As part of the measures to address financial constraints earlier this year, the government suspended foreign travels by ministers, members of parliament, and civil servants. 10 months down the road, the State Minister for Trade, Harriet Ntabazi, has cried foul over this decision, saying that it has greatly affected the performance of her ministry. She stressed that it was wrong for the government to put a ban on all travels abroad because some are very important for the development of the country. For instance, it's now hard for them to go abroad to negotiate new markets for Ugandan products.
Yes, I've realized it. I've read through the documents. I've seen nowhere among the committees. And in any, I was sharing with my sister here, where does trade fall? Is it in number one committee? Or that is manufacturing? Is it private sector? Am I a private sector? Where am I? I found myself not budgeted for at all, and not seen and not recognized.
She raised the concern today in Kampala during the launch of the 2023 activities for the Presidential Advisory Committee on Budget. The committee's core role is to ensure that the manifesto of the ruling NRM party, the National Development Plan and Vision 2040, are mainstreamed into the national planning and budgeting process. The director of the budget at the Ministry of Finance, Ishmael Magona, maintained that next financial year 2024-25, they will carry on the same theme, monetization of Uganda's economy through commercial agriculture, industrialization, expanding and broadening services, digital transformation, and market access.
The goal of the budget strategy, which you set out, is to accelerate economic growth by at least 7%. This will be achieved through a shift from a raw materials-based to a manufacturing and knowledge-based economy, but also we set out to improve the environment of doing business so as to make our economy competitive in the quest to build an independent, integrated, and self-sustaining economy.
The Minister of State for Sports, Peter Ogwang, asked the government to consider channeling more capitation grants to all seed schools across the country, but also, more importantly, prioritize the construction of AFCON stadiums, the money he said should be put in the budget for the next financial year.
For next financial year, I hope the committee takes it as a priority for us to include this in the budget for next financial year. The other one is to construct stadiums. We are looking at having at least 2 additional stadiums to allow the country be ready by 31st December 2026. So that calls for us to begin planning in terms of putting this in our main budget on as far as AFCON is concerned, and for us to attain to realize the first of its kind in East Africa.
Financing next year's budget will require effective implementation of the domestic revenue mobilization, controlling public expenditure, reducing borrowing, among others. Report by Jaliat Namwaya for the news.